Hi everyone, I'm Stephen King from Boltight. In this video, I will showcase the Typhoon Plus hydraulic tensioner. The Typhoon Plus is Nord-Lock Group's go-to product for the wind industry. Today I will show you a step-by-step process on how to correctly install and remove the hydraulic tensioners. So come follow me to the training room. So here we are with our flange and our M36 bolt, and we're gonna be working with our Typhoon Plus here. And we're gonna show you how to install it, tighten a nut, and uninstall it after we detension. All right, so it's a pretty simple setup. You set it on the bolt right there. You have a half inch ratchet, goes into the top of the puller mechanism up here on top, and we're just gonna ratchet it down into place. Now, sometimes you'll have space to be able to completely rotate all the way around like this, but sometimes you'll just be stuck and you just have to ratchet back and forth. But there's a couple ways to do it. So we're screwing down here, and what I'm paying attention to is I'm making sure that my socket slips into place. You heard it right there, snap. Once we know that socket's lined up, we don't have to worry about the nut pushing into the bottom of the socket and messing up the tensioner. So there we are, everything's set up. One thing to be very sure of is you need to make sure that your ratchet for your gearbox down here that you tighten your nut with is clear from the hose right here. It's pretty simple. You can offset one direction and one the other direction. Once the socket's seated, you can go whichever direction you need. So here we are right here. I've got my socket off to one side. I've got my hose set up off to the other side. Now, similar to the way we do our oil and gas tensioners, you don't want to screw this all the way down to where it's super tight. You want to take it down until it touches and then back it off just a little bit so there's some slack in the tensioner. All right, so I've got my tensioner there. I've got my socket ready to go here. I'm going to hook up my hose. And just like all of our other videos, you're going to want to make sure you lock the collar so that way it doesn't pop off. All right, there we go. So we're gonna pressure this up, and as it's pressured up, we're going to slowly take up the slack in the nut as it goes, okay? And there's a reason for this. You can see my socket's turning there. All right, so I'm keeping up with the pump. All right, and there we go, we're tight right there. Now the reason we do that as we take up is because if you wait for the pump to finish pressurizing and you try to screw that down, you'll have a flat spin on the nut, and you'll have to sit there and hold the back of the ratchet to keep it from spinning. So if you keep up with it, you don't have to worry about the nut getting away from you. All right, so I'm snug there, we're tight. We'll say release. All right, there we go, the pressure's off the tool, and now the nut's tight. What we do at this point was we would remove our tensioner, take it off, and then we're going to move it to the next stud, and then we would just repeat the process all the way around. So that's the installation process for the Typhoon Plus. When it comes to removal, the process is a bit different. Let's head back to the training room and I'll show you how it's done. One of the most common emergency calls we get is somebody stuck the nut onto the bottom of the tensioner while they were detensioning and they didn't know what to do. So we're gonna show you two things. We're gonna show you how to detension it, and then we're gonna discuss what to do if you do get it stuck on there. So I've got my tensioner here. We're gonna screw it onto the bolt. And we're gonna pay attention to the socket. See, it just snapped on right there. You heard it snap. So we get it screwed all the way down to the flange, and now we're touched to the flange, and here's the important part. We need to back it off a full turn. So we're gonna go full turn back. And the reason why we're doing that is we're trying to leave some slack for the nut to relax into. And so the next critical point, once we pressurize this, is you have to make sure not to back the nut off too far. We just need to back it off like two windows. So you would just move the ratchet side to side twice. So one, two, to loosen it. And that will keep the nut from going all the way up into the puller. So we'll show you that first, and then we'll discuss what to do if you get it stuck. So let me hook my hose up real quick. Again, make sure you lock your collar. All right, go ahead. So what you'll see here as he pressurizes it, you're gonna see a pretty good gap on the top. That's common. The only thing you gotta be careful of is to make sure that you don't see the red overstroke indicator. All right, there we go. So I'm gonna go one, two. That's all I've gotta do. And when we release the pump, we should feel the tensioner loosen up and you're gonna feel the nut loose, okay? Now, here's the big difference. Let's go ahead and pressurize it one more time. And I'm gonna show you what happens when you get it stuck. All right. So if I were to back this off too far, and when I go to release, what would happen is the nut gets stuck on the stud. Okay. And if that happens and I can't turn it, what I would do is to repressurize it. And as it comes up, you'll feel the nut give loose. You'll feel the nut give way. And what you need to do is run it back up to pressure. There we go. Okay. All right, we're tight right there. And I'm gonna loosen it off two windows. That's all you need to do is just two. Okay, go ahead and release. And there we are, my tensioner's loose, nut's loose. We're good to go. We can remove the tensioner and move on to the next stud. Boltight Typhoon Plus tensioners have been developed to meet the highly technical and environmental demands of the wind energy market, where bolt load and restricted access applications are common challenges. The robust design ensures reliability during the frequent and repeated use necessary on wind turbine projects on and offshore. Typhoon Plus tensioners are used for low radial clearance applications. So to summarize, the Typhoon hydraulic tensioner is safe, easy to install and remove, and have high life cycle and low maintenance costs, making them an excellent choice for wind turbine applications. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful.